regards back when I was going to school, I was very social. I knew how to talk to people, but it never felt like I really had friends. It still progressed when I got to adulthood. I knew how to talk to people. I had made some friends, but it didn't feel like the inclusive, driven, determination, dance party that you get from best buddies. And that will just always mean the world to me. When I think of inclusion, I think about all of the moments that I've shared at LC, that I've shared with my chapter, the laughs that I've had with all of my buddies that I've had. It's just that spark that adds to the plug when you become matched, but then it becomes bigger as you grow into yourself. So in 2017, I had the privilege to become eligible to travel to leadership conference in Indiana. And I had been in the auditorium for the first time with Connecticut. We all sat together. It was like, you know, the party of the century, like you just had to be there. And I believe that I was in the auditorium the moment that Kelly was speaking. Kelly Howard, she was just a bright inspiration. And I actually turned to my program manager, who I was friends with at that time, and I said, "Mike, listen, like I need to be her. Like I don't care what I have to do. I don't care what it takes, but I'm gonna do this." Just like in everything that I've done in Best Buddies, each person that I've met has willingly stopped in their tracks and wants to get to know the real me. And that's completely and utterly what Best Buddies means to me, is that each step of my way, somebody that I've gotten to interact with gets to know the real Margo. It was in the middle of the afternoon. I was at work. I had got my email on my phone, like everyone mostly does nowadays. And I literally like shrilled, like I had just won the lottery or something. "This is a 2-year commitment on the YLC. And she goes, "Oh, that's the Young Leaders Council you were talking about that you wanted to be on." And I said, "Yes." I said, "I'm on the Young Leaders Council as of right now. I'm on the Young Leaders Council." Again, I get the email telling me that I've become a co-chair. So that means that I've extended by 2 years. And I'm just, again, is this real life? Like that is like, it was like the coolest thing that has ever like happened to me the next like from 2 years. Like I was speechless. I want to be that everyday cheerleader. I want to tell people the awesome experience that I continue to have and grow with Best Buddies.
So again, I'm so excited to be able to recognize individuals and chapters as part of our Best Buddies ICU opening ceremonies in the leadership conference. But one of the things that we get so excited about every single year is an award that we refer to as our Spirit of Courage Award. And every year we work to present it to a participant who embodies all the elements of the Best Buddies mission, who works so hard on delivering and executing our Best Buddies mission around the world, who takes on leadership positions, and who truly cares so much about our mission to change the world with the power of friendship. So we're really excited to be able to present this award to someone who's here with us on stage, but she has no idea that she has flown here from Connecticut to be the recipient of the Best Buddies International Spirit of Courage Award for 2022. Alfonso, come on in. Margo, you are our Spirit of Courage 2022 award recipient for Best Buddies International because you have done so much for Best Buddies, not only as the co-chair of YLC, but as a member at Eastern Connecticut, working so hard to help propel our mission forward. And we are so grateful that you are here and that we can surprise you. So surprise! Woo! Do you have anything to say?
I kind of feel like I just am at the Grammys. So I'm gonna keep it short. Thank you so much to all of you at home for making this an absolute surprise. And for continuing to support me day in, day out. And to all of you guys for keeping the surprise You guys are just amazing people, and I want to continue being in your lives.
Well, we're so glad to have you as a part of our lives, and so many people helped make this moment special, including Garrett of the YLC and Neil Mulholland and your boss and your family. And so we were so grateful to be able to have Margo fly into Tampa to be with us here today to help present us awards, not even knowing that she is our Spirit of Courage Award winner. One more round of applause for Margo.